For the past several long months, Unitil has been out here in Kingston, New Hampshire, making major progress on their upgrade and expansion of the substation here. Now, while we've talked about scale and safety of a project of this magnitude, today we're going to talk about structures and equipment. Wow, now I can really see why they need so much prep. This is huge. It's immense. Hey guys, good to see you again. How are you? Things have changed. Boy, there is a substantial difference from the last time I was here. It seems overall a lot bigger, obviously, and clearly there are giant pieces of equipment here. Now, last time I was here, Sarah and Nate were clearing the fields, pouring the foundation, kind of landscaping the whole area, getting it ready for where we are now, I guess. So why don't you take me up to speed at what point we're at right now?
We brought in over 80,000 pounds of steel to construct all these structures that support all the bus work and major equipment.
And of course, all the wiring and cable is being installed. When we're finished, we'll have about a mile of above ground wire and almost 10 miles of wire below ground.
Wow, that's a lot of wire. I mean, I know you do need a lot of wire, but why so much?
Well, we have over 65 pieces of equipment that some require up to 40 connections between the equipment and the control house. Wow. So it's a lot of wire we have to run.
I bet. These are some big numbers you're throwing around here, and I really wish I could have been here during the whole process. I didn't get a call, I didn't know, I mean.
We figured you might be disappointed if you missed some of the more exciting stuff, so we went ahead and made a time lapse of our last
one. Oh, you did? Oh, good, let's see it.
You want to see it?
Oh, look, you're all prepared here, let's take a look.
We began by constructing the 35 kV circuit bays at the rear of the substation. Those circuit bays will support 6 outgoing distribution circuits to supply our customers. We then assembled and erected the 115 kV terminal structures that will accommodate new transmission lines from an adjacent utility. To maximize the equipment on site, we added 4 capacitor banks along the side of the substation to help mitigate losses. We also constructed 115 kV buswork and installed disconnect switches and metering devices. Next, the 1138 kV breakers were delivered and placed on their foundations at the rear of the station. We then installed lightning protection and surge arresters to provide overvoltage protection for the substation. Finally, we installed the remaining buswork to carry power throughout the station, and we're ready for transformer delivery.
Wow, that is cool. Wish I could get my home improvement projects done that quickly. So that was the framework. What happened after that?
After that framework, we installed these two 115 kV breakers and those 11 smaller 38 kV breakers and these two very large ultra low noise power transformers.
And each one of those power transformers weighs 235,000 pounds and requires a special crane with counterweights to put them in.
Yeah, they each had to be assembled, filled with 8,500 gallons of oil, tested, and then the reports had to be reviewed.
Wait, back up 1 second. So each one of these transformers is 235,000 pounds. Why? What's in them? Why are they so heavy?
Well, they're the two most heaviest pieces of equipment out here. They're that heavy because they're made up of iron, steel, copper, and oil.
Okay, well, I know a lot of this is because there's a fairly significant increase in capacity from the previous substation, but like, how much power are we talking here?
Well, we're going from 50 megawatts to about 140 megawatts, and each transformer can supply around 70 megawatts and almost 25,000 customers. With both transformers in service, we have the flexibility and redundancy to supply the community well into the future.
Wow, that is some pretty state-of-the-art stuff here.
Yep, Jake has to go, but why don't you step over here with me?
All right, Jake, good seeing you, man.
You too.
See you, Jake.
So the control house is going to sit over here, and that's essentially the brains of the substation.
Oh yeah.
So the 10 miles of cable will come through this cable trench and come into this house.
Oh yeah, these are the piers here. How big is this?
The control house will be about 16 feet wide by 50 feet long.
Now what goes on in the house? Like what's in there?
So in there is computer-based relays that control the equipment in the yard. For example, if a tree branch falls on a line out on the street, that relay would tell the circuit breaker to open, which would cause an outage. Then our dispatch center would be notified. They'd send a crew out to patrol and find the cause.
Nate, an amazing amount of work has been done so far. I'm glad you brought me up to speed. It's great, but what is next?
So next will be commission testing of the substation. And basically that's once the control house is here, everything's connected. It's basically just functional testing, make sure everything works as we planned it to.
Well, I can't wait to come back and see more. Thanks for everything.
Thank you.